The next part of this tutorial covers the front two legs and chest. A lot of this area is in shadow, so it is fairly dark compared to the rest of the body. To begin, use warm grey 1 to start filling in the base of the chest. I mark out the fold and edge lines with a slightly firmer pressure before applying the base layer with a medium pressure. I only applied the base a quarter of the way down on the leg, the rest I do further on in this video. If you go over the edge of the line, you can use a Derwent soft eraser or something similar. Brush away any eraser dust to keep your drawing nice and clean. When you get to the shoulder and top of the leg, use a firmer pressure again to define the folds and darker creases before applying a medium pressure layer to the rest of the area. I use the scribble-like motion to apply the base layer, but as it's a larger space, I use an extended oval shape. I prefer to work in this way as it means I don't get the stop-start marks you would get if you use a back and forth motion. Use dark sepia to carefully mark out the edges and folds on the chest. In this section, the folds run up the chest towards the ear. The reference is quite dark in this area, If you struggle to see the detail, you can brighten the photo slightly so that you can make out the folds. Use a medium to firm pressure to make these marks. With warm grey 4, fill in the chest area with another layer, using the scribble-like motion to work the pencil into the previous layer. If you find your hand gets hot when you work, use a sheet of glassine or tracing paper to cover and protect the drawing. Continue to apply the warm grey 4 layer down the leg. To increase the depth of shadow, use dark sepia to continue marking out the folds and creases and filling the skin in between them, reducing the pressure slightly with the latter. If you find you have drawn a cross onto the ear, you can lift it off with the sliced ceramic craft knife. This keeps the area very clean and maintains a crisp line. With dark sepia, move down the leg, focusing on the folds and creases. In this section, they create a crosshatch effect. Adjust the pressure as you change between folds and shading. Use warm grey 4 to add the next layer to the section below, working your way down the leg. Increase the shadows around the folds on the leg and chest with dark sepia. It's hard to see from the video, but I'm constantly adjusting the pressure that I'm using to apply the pencil. This creates a variety of different shades to define the lighter and darker areas along and between the folds. For the slightly lighter areas, blend with a little cold grey 4 using a medium pressure. Work your way down the leg with the three colours, using warm grey 2 as a base, defining folds and adding shading with dark sepia, and blending with warm grey 4. I only got halfway down the leg at this stage and then moved on to the shoulder and other leg. However, if you'd prefer to carry on down one leg at a time, go ahead. Use black to define the darkest shadows of the folds and leg. Work along the underneath of the ear with dark sepia and define the folds and creases on the shoulder with warm grey 4. Then blend the base layer across the top of the shoulder with cold grey 2. Make sure you have a sharp point when drawing in the shadow under the ear. Mark out the creases and wrinkles with warm grey 4, again altering the pressure used when marking the lines or shading an area. If you make an area too dark, you can lift it off with a soft eraser and then sweep away the dust to keep the paper tidy. Working your way across the shoulder, apply the base layer with warm grey 2 and define the folds with warm grey 4. Keep an eye on the warmer and cooler tones in the reference. For the area above the elbow joint, use cold grey 2 to blend the layers together with a medium pressure. Define the folds and wrinkles with warm grey 4 and work the pencil into the previous layer with the circular scribble-like motion. There is also an area of muscle that can be defined with a slightly firmer pressure across the top of the leg. Blend over the top with warm grey too. With dark sepia, continue to define the folds, wrinkles, and muscles, changing the pressure where necessary. Pay close attention to the reference to get the folds and wrinkles in the correct place as accurately as possible. Blend around the folds with warm grey 4. Increase the depth of the shadow under the ear with black and then continue to blend and define the layers to create the texture with a combination of warm grey 2 and warm grey 4. Once you have a good base, use dark sepia to add another layer of definition to the folds and creases across the shoulder and top of the leg. If there are any areas that need a little more blending, or you need a darker base before adding in the dark sepia details, blend in a little warm grey 3. Add in more definition to the large folds at the top of the shoulder, then fill in the crosshatch-like folds above the elbow. Blend over the large folds on the elbow with warm grey 3 and then begin to define the folds at the top of the leg by altering the pressure used to apply the pencil. Work in a scribble-like motion to ensure there are no stop-start marks and the pencil is blending into the paper and previous layers evenly. Go over the whole shoulder area with a light layer of warm grey 3 to blend everything together. With dark sepia, add one last layer of detail, picking out the darkest areas in the folds and wrinkles. Blend gently with warm grey 3. To fill in the rest of the leg, use cold grey 1 with a medium pressure, blending the pencil into the paper with a circular scribble-like motion. You can add in the folds and begin to define the details in this layer by increasing the pressure slightly as you go. Try to keep a nice sharp point when defining the edges of the leg. Use warm grey 3 to add in more details to the leg, following the reference to see where to place the folds. With warm grey 2, fill in the toenails. Blend in the base with warm grey 3 using a medium pressure. For the details on the leg, I've used cold grey 6, but you can use dark sepia if you wish, they are quite similar. Follow the reference to fill the folds and wrinkles up the leg. They change direction quite a lot around the knee and ankle. Getting these in the right place will help to give shape to the leg. Blend in another layer to the leg with warm grey 3, changing to cold grey 2 for the lower section, as this has a slightly cooler tone. Add another layer of dark sepia to define the folds and wrinkles laid out in the previous layers. Blend over the whole leg with a layer of warm grey 4, marking out the wrinkles with a varying pressure, concentrating on the areas around the knee and ankle. With dark sepia, define the skin around the toenails and the base of the foot. Continue to blend in the layer of warm grey 4, defining the folds. Look closely at where the light hits the fold and add the shadow to the bottom of each one. Add a little more dark sepia to the bottom of the leg. To add highlights to the top of the toenails, you can use a slice tool to gently take away a little of the darker layers to reveal the lighter layers beneath. Then blend gently with warm grey 3 and raw umber 10%. Continue to add the shadows to the foot, blending with cold grey 2. Work your way up the leg, adding the shadows to the left side where it is darkest and defining the wrinkles again with a firm pressure. There are a few little details on the skin which you can add in. Here there are some dark spots on the inner leg. Apply a medium to firm pressure to scribble in one spot to create the marks. The folds around the knee are quite large, so the shadows are more intense. Focus on this area, looking at the reference closely to check you get the placement of the shadows correct. Blend the layers together with warm grey 3. Work over the top of the whole leg to add another layer of detail with dark sepia. Blend over the larger folds with warm grey 4, then continue to define the wrinkles to make sure they stand out from the shadowed layers. Define the darkest shadows with black under the ear and on the top of the leg. Then use dark sepia to define the shadows a little more down the rest of the leg. This process can feel very repetitive, but adding the layers gradually and continuing to define the details helps to create a more realistic finish. Pick out the highlights on the folds with raw umber 10%, applying the pencil to the top where the light hits. This helps to create more shape and definition. For any areas with a warmer tone, add a little blending layer of raw umber 50% using a medium pressure. Add one last layer of detail to the folds and wrinkles with dark sepia, going over the edges with a sharp point. If you do get any pencil out of the line, like I did here, use an electric eraser to clean it up. Moving over to the other front leg, complete the base layer with warm grey 2 up the whole leg, marking out the folds with an increase in pressure. Once you have applied the base of the whole leg, begin to define further with dark sepia. Use the reference closely to follow the change in direction and size of the folds and wrinkles. For any areas without a base, make sure you add that in first. Use warm grey 2 to apply the base layer in the same way as before, with a medium pressure and a circular scribble-like motion. Add in the shadow behind the elbow with dark sepia. With warm grey 4, add in the long fold lines running down the body, behind the shoulder and elbow, then blend together with warm grey 2. Use dark sepia to mark out the edges of the toenails and the folds that create the subtle shape of the toes and foot. Blend the shadows with warm grey 4 using a medium pressure and circular scribble-like motion. Add a second layer to the ankle with warm grey 2. There is a cooler tone to the back of the ankle, which can be added with a layer of cold grey 1. With warm grey 3, add in the rest of the details up the leg, defining all the folds and wrinkles. Use dark sepia to go over all the details and increase the shadows on the foot, using a medium to firm pressure and varying it slightly as you go. With warm grey 4, add another layer to define the details and increase the shadows. Define the darkest shadows with a combination of black and dark sepia, making sure you have a nice sharp pencil for the edges. If you find an area has become too dark, use a putty rubber to gently lift the pencil off and then blend over with warm grey 3, reapplying any details needed with dark sepia. Add in the highlights to the toes and toenails with raw umber 10%. With dark sepia, define the folds and wrinkles further along the rest of the leg, applying the darkest colour to the base of the folds, picking out the areas in shadow. Once you've covered the whole leg with the wrinkles and fold markings, apply another layer, this time increasing the depth of the shadowed areas by increasing the pressure slightly. For the areas on the back of the leg where the tone is cooler, apply the details and shading with a layer of cold grey 6. Use black to define the darker shadows along the front edge of the leg using a medium pressure. Add a light to medium pressure layer to the remainder of the leg with cold grey 6 using the circular scribble-like motion. Go back over the middle of the leg with another layer of dark sepia, defining the folds and wrinkles further. Blend over the folds around the foot with a layer of warm grey 4. With dark sepia, increase the depth of the shadows around the ankle. Pick out the last few details with black, increasing the depth of the shadowed areas and defining the folds and wrinkles around the knee and foot. This section of the baby elephant is now complete. The third and last part of the tutorial will cover the body and back legs to see your drawing through to completion. If you have any questions about this part of the tutorial, please get in touch and I'll be happy to help.